Hi, my friends. This is day 11. And yes, I'm still alive. And I'm okay. And today is actually a little bit calmer video. Because on day 10, which is very typical, I start to have ketoacidosis crisis, which means that the body goes deeper healing, to tell it nicely, and you start to detoxify more strongly for a few days. And this actually means that there is no worry about it. Sometimes it can be pretty aggressive, and then I probably would recommend some enema, which means that you a little bit lighter the detoxification process. But for example, for me it's not so strong, so I don't think I need it, but I take already enemas in bag at the beginning. And when I feel really, really sluggish, but I don't take it really often during the fast, because the fasting is already itself healing. And I basically get rid of any mucuses or fatigue or inflammation. And this time it's actually that the mucus that I have in my body due to Lyme disease is actually getting rid of me. And the difference is that it's not like you get cough and then you're like, oh my god, some chest in my throat or lungs, or you have clotted stuff, a phase, and you cannot get rid of it. It's more like at the end of the disease, when you start to get it off you, and you start to be every single cough, every single blowing your nose, you will be better. And that's how I feel. So yes, right now it's a little bit detoxification, but it's not a big deal. So, but it's good maybe at the time, at least I feel like this, a little bit rest, relax, maybe sleep more. I personally want to sleep more. And then after a few days it's gone, it's usually way better. And then you go a little bit, again, like kind of neutral, and then maybe there will be one more before the 21 day. So it's up to different body, but that's how it is usually. And that's my experience actually pretty much every time, and it's my third time. Before it was different disease, now it's Lyme disease, but it's pretty much working for any disease, I believe so. So, but what I do to prevent mucus on daily basis without water fast is actually that I eat, it's called mucusless nutrition, because my body naturally goes a lot of mucus. I have autoimmune disease, and it's perfectly eliminated if I am on mucusless diet. And it may last for a few years, because usually, I know that many doctors doesn't want to hear it, and some people don't believe it, but I believe it's caused a lot by vaccination. And yes, I was vaccinated a few times, actually a lot of times in the past. Not as much as Americans, but I was. And I never put it in the, like, time schedule on the top. Sometimes the symptoms come up later, you know, a few years later, when you accumulate a lot of toxins from food or stress or whatever. So what happened to me is actually, I pretty much am symptom free on such a diet. And yes, some people, when they get better, they heal, you know, after, usually it takes about 7 years to completely recover. It depends on the body again. But yes, it really does help a lot. And then if somebody goes back to paleo or whatever, or normal eating, just organic, well, everybody's choice. I personally, after the water fast, have no desire to go that much back, because I'm naturally turned to lighter food, feel lighter, feel happier, because it makes me feel happier, really it does. And it's not that, of course, there is also situation happiness, right? Like when you're sad from some situation or happy from some situation. But it actually, for me, means that I feel more sensitive to my senses, And also it means that I can also like let go of my stress more easily. And also, of course, I feel a little bit down when something happened bad, but just eating a mango, the sugar and the really good sugar and organic, just makes my mood better. And usually for me it works actually the oranges. That actually makes me happy, and even the smell of the oranges. That's my way. However, what I want to mention is that mucusless diet, and number one mucusless food is actually, regardless of your diet, is probably for me pineapple. And I actually tried it with even other people who are not on a raw vegan diet or any diet, and they approve it. You know, it calms the inflammation even in the joints when you are sick. It helps eliminate any mucus from you, even from your ear when you eat it. But if you stuff yourself with the milk after that, even organic, I'm not so sure it will work as well. So I would probably stick with at least 1 to 3 days just pineapple. You can survive it, trust me. If I can survive on water, you can survive on pineapple for a few days. And you don't need to buy any expensive pills. Plus, then you have to detoxify over the years your pills, you know. Maybe not over the little time. But that's the problem. People get to comfort zone when they see, okay, I get to work, I get to home, I have fun, I have party, then I have family, then I get sick and I take pills. Everything has some kind of concept in this world, and it's very attractive because you don't have any responsibility for yourself, and you just, well, you do kind of, but not really the important one. And you just go to the doctor pretty much to take care of you like a mommy, right? But on the other side, I think it's you know, even those people who are in faith, even though those people, regardless if they choose different diet, they don't believe any diabetes, because they don't believe that their God is meant to create them with diabetes. There is no such a thing as diabetes or anything like that. So don't believe in such a thing, right? And those people who are in that situation, they usually take even more flu shots and other shots. And not just that it's ineffective, but it also, it caused a lot of other trouble, like mercury poisoning, other poisoning, and over the time, oh my god, it can be a pretty mess. Just check it out, you know. And back to quickly to the mucusless diet, if you stick with the organic fruit and organic vegetables, it will a little bit help you out. And if it's not enough at the time because you're a lot of overload, then it goes to juicing. And maybe later on in water fast, probably supervised, especially for the beginners, I really recommend it because it can be a little bit dangerous and scary and stuff. However, a very good thing is to consider go no nuts before you heal your body. Once you heal your body, the nuts will not, organic ones sprouted, will not make you sick. I tried on myself, I wasn't able to eat it, then I was. Even the spices and stuff, I was after that, not when I'm sick. So, just saying. And if you stick with any other diet, then you're welcome. Just find your own way, but be careful. Sometimes we don't see the symptoms, we see just a little bit of inflammation, a little bit of weakness and stuff, just like any athlete. But those people actually, when they really want to have benefit, they go raw organic diet. Okay, find your way, don't trust anybody, and go slowly step by step and really eliminate it from your stomach, from your lungs, because when you are overloaded, it goes out different ways, like lungs, skin, depends on the different toxins. Okay, I really have to go again. It's always such a short time to talk, and maybe I like to talk. So I hope you have a good day, and really don't be worried, and just enjoy your life. You have everything you need, even when you don't have anything, because everything is provided within you if you find the truth. Bye.